Hello, welcome to Telecom TV. We are at the Great Telco Debate 2019 here in London. I am talking with Frans Zeiser, who is Group Technology VP at Deutsche Telekom. Frans, thanks for talking to us. Good to see you.
Thanks for having me. Great pleasure.
Cloud native, is it a must-do or would be nice to do for the CSPs as the transition towards digital service providers accelerates?
I think cloud native is a must-do on our way forward. The question is more, how do we transition there? What are the timelines? But if we are serious, and we are serious, on our vision to become a software telco and do the key parts of our value creation in software, having cloud native, which is a broad term anyhow, as a key technology path and process how we produce is absolutely essential going forward.
Okay, given that, what use cases do you believe will generate near-term revenue opportunities for CSPs such as Deutsche at the edge, and why?
First of all, we need to discuss a bit what do we mean by edge. It's not so well defined, so everyone is talking edge. Edge can be our existing, what we would call central offices. It could be even more centralized, but it also could be on the customer premise once we talk more industrial type use cases. And actually, I believe these industrial use cases are short term the most promising one. Why is that? Because we always talk about low latency, but actually European countries tend not to be that big. So you don't need to have 50 data centers in, not even if you take UK. If you consider that light on the fiber is going back and forth in 1 millisecond, 100 kilometers, you still can do with a decent amount of sites, right? But once you go into industrial and they do their control of their production floors, then you really go into this extremely low latency part, but also data privacy is key for them. So I can imagine they have big demand to keep the data local. And this is the edge where it will happen anyhow. And either we manage to play a role there by being able to cooperate with them, to utilize, if you ask me, their infrastructure they are building there, and not saying we come with our own infrastructure and do our own infrastructure lifecycle, but we can utilize what you have. This is probably the most near-term use cases. And to utilize that infrastructure they have, this is exactly where cloud-native paradigms, like you have portable software that can run on that infrastructure available to be able to set up your network control entities down there.
Put you on the spot a bit, if I might. If you had to pick one, which of these is the key driver for change in the market, do you think? First is technology, the second is business models, the third is investment, the fourth is culture, and the fifth is skill set. So what is the key driver out of those, do you think? I know it's a bit artificial, but I'm trying to get some sense of where things lie.
Well, the driver has to come out of business, I believe, because we are here to make business. But to achieve that, it's primarily about culture and skill set. The rest follows. We never had a problem that technology was not there. We always had a problem to make use of the technology properly, especially as telco, and that comes out of our culture and comes out of our skill set that always hindered us on moving as fast as we would like to sometimes.
Okay, so business model, yes, so the technology is a given. It has to be there for it to be worth even doing. Then business models, then culture and skill set, and then finally investment.
Yes.
Why does investment come last?
Investment follows where the opportunities are. That's at least my view. Investors want to have a certain return on invest, so they look where is the opportunity, and they don't want to have artificial opportunities, they want to have real opportunities. So then it has to be a certain story and plausible way forward, so they see if they go in there, they will get it. And for that, all the surroundings have to be there, and again, that includes, of course, the aforementioned things from business down to culture and skill sets.
How do you think CSP vendor business models need to adapt to accelerate telco transformation?
That depends strongly on the vendor, honestly. Yeah. So of course, we do have a broad choice of vendors, and some coming from a very classical box shifting type of business. So they are very hardware centric, and software has seen on supporting the hardware. But on the other end, we already do see smaller, more software centric vendors that are not so much bound to these kind of things. And that's probably more likely what we want to see going forward. Software focused companies being flexible and driving things. But honestly, the one thing is, of course, the vendor business model. So really being able to do business and be more software centric. But that also puts back a burden on us as service providers. Classical procurement models with tenders and purchasing and having specified every single feature for the next 12 or 18 months for accounting reasons is not really helpful in that setting. So we as an industry, we need to learn much more how we work in a more partnership mode, and not everything is crystal clear for the next 18 months when you sign a contract.
Okay, second question allied to this really. Should CSPs, do you think, regard the hyperscalers as competitors or potential future business partners?
It depends very much in what area. Hyperscalers have a broad set of things they're looking in, and businesses they do, same for us. And there are areas where partnership is definitely a way to go. And one is the aforementioned, if you think about industries and production, many of them do have agreements with some of the hyperscalers, so they may have already infrastructure down there or plan to deploy. Mm-hmm. I believe it's easier if we come in and say, hey, you have this infrastructure of that player, very good, we can make use of it, so we can run our software there. But there are other areas in our network where we may not be so happy to cooperate that closely with them, and would be more in a competition mode.
Let's come and talk about Deutsche directly now. What work have you done so far with Cloud Native?
For Cloud Native, we look Cloud Native in a network environment, to be a bit more precise. On IT side, I think we are more advanced, but for networking, we are clearly in a learning phase. What we see when we look a bit what's happening in the industry, the first big network function that we will get delivered in Cloud Native is famous 5G core, not the least because we have been successful as a community to write 3GPP specs in a way that the ease or even the favor an implementation in Cloud Native manner, even though of course 3GPP does not dictate, but what we see is all the players, regardless if they are the more classical ones or the new ones, they re-implement 5G core from scratch in Cloud Native. Fortunately, we kicked off to start working on that one, and we do have lab trials going. Why fortunately? Because we figured out it's a long way to go. It's very, very different to what you have seen, what we have seen in box type and also virtualized environment, which is still very close to what we knew from the box world. For Cloud Native, things start to be very different, many new tools, many new environments, and there is quite a learning curve going forward, and we are in the middle of that learning curve.
Back to Cloud Native, how do you see it rolling out in the longer term? We've covered the short term and being used. What do you think is going to happen with Cloud Native?
First of all, Cloud Native will develop itself over time. So what we call Cloud Native today may not be 100% what you call Cloud Native in 3 years from today. So it's a developing methodology, unless a new buzzword comes in, obviously. We may call it differently. We're good at that.
True.
See? It will come gradually. The big question is how do you bring this, and Cloud Native is not only about technology, it's a lot about culture and mindset. Yeah? How do you operate as this software telco? How do you bring your people on this new culture? It has to do with agile teams, with empowered people, decision taking on team level, not everything going up the hierarchy to whatever level where people anyhow are not qualified anymore to do technical decisions. To really change that culture and move in that one, having these smaller entities that can work together, it will come gradually, step by step. The question is, how do you bring that into your network? Do you find a dedicated area, like for example 5G Core, and this one we do in a cloud native manner from scratch, kind of almost greenfieldish inside the company, so it's a bit isolated from the rest and can move? Or do you try to move your whole production in smaller steps but more in sync all across the board forward? I personally believe the do it in an isolated manner first and let them move and learn and then run it out is probably the more favorable one. But in the end, again, if the vision is softwareized telco, you have to have that across your whole production landscape.
How confident are you, France, that your suppliers and your partners are up to speed with cloud native, that they know what they're doing and they can actually help you in what you at Deutsche Telekom want to do?
Actually, I'm pretty confident. As said before, when we looked on what they're doing at 5G Core, we saw that all of them are really now going in that to that direction. A little bit different stages of development, of course, but I think we have a broad understanding across the industry that that is the way to go. That may be thanks to already a couple of years of NFV, where we had really a learning curve to go. We learned a lot what does not work properly, which is most of the time if you stick too much to your legacy way of doing things, that caused that rethink. And finally, all of them concluded the only way forward is to fund them to really re-implement the things going forward.
Final question to you. How do you think the vendor business models themselves need to change to accommodate what you need from cloud native?
They need to become much more software-centric business models. Today, you still see a lot of heritage, so to say, from hardware-inspired business models, and we really need to learn how we do these models in a software environment.
I said it was the last question, but given what you just said, I'll ask you another one. So how long do you think it is going to be before we reach that point?
As I said before, it depends a lot on the vendor. For some, it will be very easy because this is their DNA. For others, I think they need to, if I'm nasty, they may need to risk to lose a couple of projects before they see that their model doesn't work anymore.
Okay, thank you.
My pleasure.